Now, Human Settlements Minister Mmamoloko Kubayi says she's not impressed with the pace at which houses are being delivered to the residents of Limpopo. Kubayi was at Modimolle yesterday handing out title deeds to new homeowners. It was all part of her two-day visit to assess the state of housing in that province. Newzroom Africa's Linda Mnisi was there.
Modimolle Lucky Joseph.
The stage is but a dream for millions of South Africans. Some even die while waiting on the government's promise to deliver houses. Those left behind can only pin their hopes on the infamous house waiting list, wondering when their names will be called.
The list currently is not reliable. I want to be quite frank about it. One is that when you look at that list, it's done, it's developed, it has to be generated from municipalities and then would have it in terms of the provinces. But when you look at it in where it is now, you find that it varies based on the municipality's performance, the province performance, whether they update it in time, and it's almost not automated. What I would want to see as a minister, it's a system that even as a beneficiary, I can go and update my details. If I'm staying in Limpopo and I apply for a PNG in Limpopo and I decide to move because I'm going to look for a job in Johannesburg, but I get a job and I no longer need a PNG because I think I will settle in Johannesburg, but I need a low-cost house, I should be able to go to a system and update my details in terms of where I need the beneficiary as a beneficiary to say I no longer fall in the PNG category, but I now fall into the flips market. And therefore the system updates it and then I can be able to get, then it moves, it updates and then you are able to provide the service. We are not there and that's where I want us to be as a country in terms of our database.
Over the past 2 days, the minister visited beneficiaries and those on the waiting list, some in frustration. At the beginning of this financial year, Limpopo had set a target of handing over 4,357 new housing units. 510 million rand had been budgeted for this. 4,098 service stands would also be delivered to beneficiaries, while 1,905 title deeds would be handed out. But it seems the province is lagging behind.
I think Limpopo can do better. I'm not happy with the targets. That's why we've put together a team that they need to do a recovery plan. They will have to provide that report by Friday next week to me to say this is the recovery plan, because I do think that in terms of the numbers that we need to be able to meet our target by the financial year and also our spending, it's going to be important for us to increase the pace.
At the sites visited by the minister on Thursday, 165 low-cost houses started in March had been completed in Sishego Township. At Bendo in Polokwane, 158 units had been completed. The target here is 661 units.
You might have seen when we were in extension 133 yesterday, high-capacity contractors were on site. They should have been on site earlier than now. If our planning was right, we could have made them to be on the 1st of April when we start the financial year. They delayed, and that's why I think the approach we have taken to put high capacity in one particular area, you might have seen when we were there yesterday, a lot of material are on site. We think by no time the expenditure and the delivery of the houses will be at the way we should be. You may have seen we were somewhere around 30%, when in fact we should be somewhere around 45-50%. So I'm pushing towards making sure that we meet the targets.
Crisscrossing the country, Minister Kubayi has so far been to 6 provinces and will soon be visiting other provinces to assess the state of the delivery of houses. For Newsroom Africa on Channel 405, I'm Lynn Damnesi in Limpopo.